Forgive me for that interruption. I've disconnected the phone so we can continue. We're talking about the, presumably, the gathering of the mayim underneath the firmament is directly touching the firmament, as it were. But for the sake of illustration, I'm just using this chart here. This gathering of the waters, the dry land somehow came out of that. Somehow it's out of that. Now, the next question is going to be, I'm going to have to use a different sheet of paper because this is getting complicated. Once you have the Mayim, and I'm drawing it as a sphere, but it might not be a sphere. Once you have this gathering in one place, and then the dry land appearing, what if we illustrated it this way? This is a second illustration. What if we have the Mayim above the firmament, then the gathering of the waters, the gathering of the waters, then the dry earth. My next question is going to be, is there anything underneath the earth? Is there anything, if this is the dry land, the square box there, if that's the dry land that appeared out of the gathered waters, is it just floating on top? Is there anything underneath it? Again, conceptually speaking, where is this? Is it to have equal amount of water all the way around it, this dry land that appears? And this is the sea, is it completely surrounded by sea? Or is it half and half? What's underneath the land? I don't want to mess up our theories of phenomenology here, but there are many verses later in the Bible that refer to, speaking of this Genesis account, waters under the earth, the waters above the earth, that is on the other side of this firmament, and then the waters under the earth. But it doesn't say that here at this point. But it is a question that you should be asking if you're carefully paying attention to this situation. The waters under the firmament, under the heaven, maybe we should call that atmosphere, would that help? We don't know what it is. It doesn't say what it is. It's something that divided the waters from under it, from those above it. That's all it says. Call it heaven. If it helps, think of it as atmosphere. I'm not sure. Because that implies air and gases and all kinds of things that are also compressions, less compressed than matter. But you see, we're talking about compression here. Creation seems to be a matter of compression. And I'll put that in your PhD thesis, your scientific thesis, because that's what we're talking about. It's a gathering. Matter is a gathering. And we had the gathering of the waters underneath the firmament, and dry land came out of them. Matter, non-water, non-gas, non-water. Solid. Solid came out of oblivion, the compression of oblivion. So now we have earth, and God saw that it was good. The third day, but only the second time, he saw that it was good. He judged that it was a good thing. So let us proceed.